It's music time at the drive-in, with a dangerous look into the music industry with Wild Guitar. Wild Guitar, released in 1962, stars Arch Hall Jr. in one of seven films he's ever involved in, alongside his father Arch Hall Sr. and his band, Arch Hall Jr. and the Archers. Having come off the future Mystery Science Theater 3000 target EGA, Archie stars in this B-movie comedy drama musical as Bud Eagle, a singer-songwriter who came to Hollywood to make it big, but winds up getting involved in the shady dealings of the music record industry. This movie was directed by Ray Dennis Teckler, who would also direct another future MST3K target, the incredibly strange creatures who stopped living and became mixed-up zombies. It was also written up partially by Arch Sr. under the pseudonym Nicholas Merriweather. It was made with a presumed $30,000 budget, and it was distributed by Fairway International Pictures, much like the other Arch Jr. pictures like Iga, the exploitable serial killer The Sadist, alongside the incredible strange creatures and a silly lewd comedy called Magic Spectacles. The movie features Arch Jr.'s natural music performing talents that would later be put into an anthology album, and a pretty decent talent he displayed for the short time as a musician and actor before becoming a commercial airline pilot and eventually an author of an erotic action-adventure novel, Absar Ajet, under the same pseudonym that his father used. Will this rags-to-riches story be better or worse than our previous attempt, Elvis Presley's Lovin' You? How about we park it and find out?
Blanket Bingo
series. I don't like him. His name's Archie. My name's Archie's Weird Mysteries. I hated that series.
I love that series. Shut up. Don't hate it.
I hate you now.
Bunga 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 bungle.
Archie Hall Jr. looks like a douchebag, and yes, it is because his name is Archie.
Let's go, Moondoggy.
All right.
Archie's like a name you commit crimes to.
Look at how he's going fast there, Daddy-O. Shit.
See, look, he committed a crime, destruction of property.
His own property.
Yeah, he has to sue himself now, right? That's how that works.
What's that dude from the Speed Buggy cartoon?
You know, I just think of Speed Racer. This is Speed Racer on a fucking motorcycle.
Oh my god, this is a movie.
It is.
What is he, some biker bad boy greaser guy?
Essentially?
Ooh. You got my attention.
Well, I'm the kind of guy that likes
like
to roll
around.
Ba-dum, ba-dum.
Town, and when I find myself falling for some girls, I roll around, 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 around,
around, around, around, around, around, and then it's gonna be the baby that I take out tonight.
N-G-O-B.
Capitol Records. Imagine you'll be able to make music for a fucking heartless corporation.
Ooh, sounds bodacious.
Yeah, it's like all the corporations, though, man. They have to. Are they equally heartless or like in various tiers?
This is a story of Johnny Guitar.
Johnny Guitar.
You know what's really
funny?
The
world's greatest guitarist of all time.
Before I knew my husband's real name, I thought his name was Johnny for the longest time, like his real name.
Johnny!
I wish pompadours never really went out of style. They're really sexy.
Johnny! Okay, Kitty, if you want an area where pompadours never went out of style, watch more anime.
Yeah, go to Japan. They never went out of style.
They love pompadours.
I've noticed that like Japan really likes parts of American culture.
Yes.
Yeah, they love
it's
us.
Like,
but
man,
at
it's
the same time, they like hate people that aren't Japanese, if I'm correct.
Yes and no. That's more of a diverse thing about the culture. Japanese people who like American culture don't hate American people as much as Japanese people who want to keep their traditions.
Get out of the fucking way!
Oh, sorry. Gee willikers.
I could go around, but I'm a lazy ass.
Man, other car, you can go, you know.
Man, come on, I'm going around the world, man. I'm rolling around, 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 around. You know, ground handprint, some people just don't understand that I'm the type of guy that likes to roll around.
Oh, also, our character's name, Bud Eagle.
I like it.
My name's Bud Eagle. This is my story. You might wonder how I got here and shit. Look at that dude.
What is that face? Just like, hey, I just took a poof. It felt
so
great.
Hot.
Another interview, huh?
I'm going to be on the Hellcat and TV program.
They got 7-Up, Gonzo. You know how hard that shit is to come by, 7-Up?
Go to 7-Eleven.
There's no 7-Up at 7-Eleven, man. You tripping.
Did you look?
What's a 7-Eleven anyways? We're in the 1950s, dude.
Wait a minute, hold on.
What's that? Me thinks it's a hick.
A hick? Oh no.
7-Eleven was found in 1927. It started out as an ice house storefront in Dallas, named Totem Stores in between 1928 and 1946, and then became 7-Eleven afterwards.
Rick, they called us hicks. You know what that means. Time to suck some dick!
What'll it be?
Do you have a menu?
Sure.
Oh no! He only has 10 cents. That'll give him a room for the night.
Yeah. I'll buy him a house.
I don't have enough money for chicken nugget.
Chicken nuggets.
I got you.
You know how refined that chicken is? Only rich people can have chicken
nuggets. Damn, he bought a whole club sandwich and all. Some chips.
That could barely get you a fucking drink nowadays, Jesus.
Going to a restaurant, I'd like some fried chicken.
You got a coffee for that much. Wow.
Only rich people can have fried chicken, honey.
The very bourgeoisie can afford a full Kentucky fried chicken meal.
Who needs freeways?
She's a little confused. I think it's the gasoline tax that goes to the freeways.
What's the gasoline tax for nowadays?
Making gas companies richer, I guess? I don't fucking know.
Yeah, we don't pay for freeways anymore. The state kind of covers that shit.
Well, toll roads and all that.
I'm gonna shut my mouth now. I just realized what taxes are.
Are you a musician?
Well, now, I wouldn't go as far as to say that.
I read somewhere how many thousands of kids come to Hollywood each year, but I forgot the exact number.
Thousands? We're here for a nice swinging spring break soiree.
What the hell am I hearing?
Kitty's like destroying her laundry.
She's just like sitting on it, I don't know.
I've got a letter from the manager of the radio station at Spearfish.
Spearfish?
Whose kid is that? Where the hell did he come from?
This was back when they let kids roam on their own into random places unsupervised, Gonzo.
They technically still do, but it's gotta be for a Netflix series.
You so right.
You can listen to her, she knows what she's talking about.
Hey, are you in show business?
She sure is.
Really? Maybe I haven't heard of you.
Hardly. I'm still trying to get my foot in the door, and I was born here.
Well, you're trying to get your foot in the door.
I know she's trying to get her foot in the door, but
I'm trying to get my foot in the door. Want to make an equally inadequate kid? I like the color red. You like the color red too? Let's fuck.
Oh yeah.
Private, pass the Crayola.
Let's go to the malt shop, guys.
I don't want to go to the malt shop. It gives me gas.
I want to go for the malt shop.
Riggy, I don't know. I'm getting a little too old for the malt shop. What about you?
You're never too old for the malt shop.
I feel like my bowels become an active volcanic hazard around the malt shop. Category 5 earthquake.
That's Taco Bell, you're thinking.
Probably.
Slapstick comedy.
Yes!
Let's do this twist again like we did last summer, baby!
Boogie boogie.
Engaging something so inappropriate. I'm offended.
Ugh, dancing's too gross. Get off the
screen. Oh, look at her gyrating. What is she, by the devil? Ugh.
Who has this lost footage of me, like, dancing in my home?
Yeah, especially when you give, like, that iconic I just farted kind of look.
I'm trying to sneak out a fart without it becoming a shart.
Yeah, that's the face. Trying to sneak out a fart without it becoming a shart.
You just distract everyone when you're dancing and hope to God you're so wide they won't notice you. You're almost shitting your pants.
How white I am.
When you gyrate your shoulders like that, you're desperately trying not to piss yourself.
Go, Daddy, go!
Johnny, be good!
feel sick.
You don't have time to die, man. You better get on there and be dead.
Uh-huh.
No, don't throw up in the fuck. Don't throw up on a fucking in a fucking saxophone. Throw up at the Japanese Prime Minister.
Ew.
Which has happened. It has happened.
I have standards, Gonzo. Throw up on the Chinese Prime Minister.
We're in trouble. Now what?
Our next spot ran out on us.
What?
He was scared to death. I couldn't stop him, Hal.
Well, think of something.
I've got a singer for you.
What?
Well, he's right here, and he's very good.
Now, wait a minute.
I haven't heard an ounce of his music. I'm just going by how he says he's good.
Listen to the woman. She has an opinion.
And a vagina.
God damn it. You look like Lex Luthor, man.
Man, he let himself go, did he?
Yeah, damn straight he did. Lex Luthor eating too many of the Twinkies.
He ate all those fucking cakes. He ended up stealing like 40 cakes. That's like 4 tens.
He like ate Theodore Roosevelt too.
Jesus.
You can tell.
He just ate everybody. It's okay. Oh!
He did. Well, there goes my guitar.
Who's the asshole that tripped me? I'll fucking bop you in the next week.
Yes, it's a comedy show. Laugh, people.
Totally planned, by the way. Totally planned.
What's your name, son?
My name's Bud Eagle.
Well, I see you brought along your own band. Let's fly.
I'm gonna love you, baby. Yes, I will. 'Cause you opened my eyes and gave me such a thrill.
Yeah.
Such a thrill, such a thrill, such a thrill.
We can't show most of this because it's probably copyrighted. Yeah.
TCM probably picked this up and tried to colorize the fuck out of it, so it's probably public domain.
DCM could own the rights, though. See, people kind of do this thing where even if they don't own the rights, they submit a thing to the copyright system.
Trying to make it a little bit of original so that we don't get copyrighted.
Fraud, but no one prosecutes it. There's like tons of laws being broken by the system, actually. Somebody should totally do something about that.
Now mention something about sacrificing chickens to the name of Satan.
Talk about how you're gonna dance in tangent with a black man. They hate miscegenation. Don't actually do it, just say you're gonna do it.
Claim you slept with a lot of women. That's what Gene Simmons did.
More than 12. Way more than 12.
Dozens, thousands.
Billions, trillions. Go insane, do decadillions. Make it an impossible number. They'll never investigate. Your sexual appetites cannot be satisfied by even Apollo, the god of the sun himself.
I'm your biggest fan. Yeah, Daddy-O.
Thank God you saved me from failing television ratings.
Well, boys, cancel those plans to move to Tahiti. We're not unemployed yet.
Yes, I saw him. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, yes, yes, I handle him.
It was a goddamn train wreck, and everyone loved it.
Oh, God, I can't even say that. That's my fucking son that we're talking about. Literally,
nah, never mind.
This guy here, that's Arch Jr.'s fucking father.
Wait, what?
Literally. His father has been involved in many of the other films that Archie Jr. has been involved in as well. In fact, Nicholas Merriweather, one of the writer's names that we've seen in the opening credits,
yeah,
that's a pseudonym for Arch Sr.
What? This motherfucker's in every movie.
I have no idea what's going on in this. All I know is that the kids sing and that I can't tell who's who.
Oh, that's Bobby-O, Daddy-O, and Johnny-O.
Oh, okay, thank you. That's Bobby-O, Daddy-O, and Johnny-O.
Fuck it, that's all you need to know.
Come back sometime when I'm not so busy. Yeah, Lou.
Yeah, you need my social security number for what now?
I enjoyed your singing. Maybe you can get someplace.
Thank you.
Of course, that doesn't mean that you will. Takes a lot of hard work in this business. I want to point this out to you. It takes a lot of money to put a personality before the public.
And a whole lot of cocaine, son. A whole lot. More cocaine than you could ever fathom. You need to sniff cocaine off of a hooker's ass crack, son. You need to drink cocaine with your orange juice, son.
Buy a Coke. It used to come with cocaine.
Is that my 4 o'clock cocaine?
All right, bud, now you go and take your bow, and after it's all over, come back, and we'll have a talk.
Yes, sir.
Get my fucking cocaine, Charlie.
What'd he say?
To get me his cocaine or something, I don't know.
He was all over the place. I think he was on meth.
Well, is he gonna take you?
I don't know, but he wants to talk to me afterwards.
Sounds good.
No, he's on cocaine.
Why does she sound so horny, like, oh, yeah.
The 50s, wasn't everyone that way?
I don't know. I don't think anybody was
horny. I want a blue dress for the 50s and 40s, guys. I'm on eBay.com.
Listen, I love vintage fashion. I grew up with a lot of vintage or older media.
Okay, well, shouldn't you know this?
Well, I don't think I'm horny all the time.
I'm horny.
Exit out. Emergency meeting.
Please.
I'm horny. Horny, 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 horny.
Put the fucking Mr. McCulley voice. What was with that music and then going into the apartment like something sinister was about to happen?
It's a meta mystery.
Yes. Shame. Behold, my cocaine monastery. There is cocaine inside each and every single wall.
A swimming pool.
There's cocaine in the
swimming right outside my window.
Snob had a better joke. A swimming pool. It's a bathtub, you idiot.
Boy, you really must be from the shit part of town. That's a swimming pool, son. I mean, a bathtub.
Oh, he did say he's from the Dakota, so...
Now you've got a lot of things to do tomorrow, so you better hit the sack.
And by the sack, I mean all that cocaine I got in your bedroom. If you are not blitzing, by the time I see you in the morning, you're not going on stage.
Ah, young Rudy Giuliani enjoy his first wine.
There's cocaine in the wine. Wait, no.
That would explain how Rudy Giuliani is such a fucking mess now.
You know, being a star is serious business. It's going to take a lot of your time.
A star?
A star cocaine.
Oh my God.
I left my suitcase at that restaurant.
Well, it's all right. Steak will get it for you.
Well, there's somebody there waiting for me.
Somebody? But you're nobody. Nobody's can't meet somebody.
Star my cocaine car.
God.
Okay, kid. Do what you want to do.
Thanks, Mike. I'll be right back.
Not to me, you won't. You can take your guitar with you. Looks like we'll get ourselves another boy.
Man, I don't think he should be driving. I think he's, drunk.
You think I made a big thing out of picking up that suitcase, don't you?
Well, yeah.
That's right, I did. An hour more or less isn't important.
That's what I said.
But it told me something. It told me that you weren't ready to take orders. If I had an interview or an appointment, I couldn't be sure that you'd be there.
Oh, but I would, Mr. McCulley. Honest.
If you thought it was important.
No!
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 If you're not gonna do the cocaine, I won't explain.
Would you please give me one more chance?
No more arguments?
No, nothing. Only what you tell me.
And that's the toxic relationship with Hollywood, folks.
And you will be my number one guy.
And you tell that girl of yours, I bet she'll be happy when she sees all those new suits we're gonna get for you tomorrow.
Oh, she's not my girl.
I wish she was.
The Coffee Cup Cafe on La Brea. You know that is, Dave?
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
Now don't you worry, Steak will take care of everything.
They won't take care of a damn thing.
You really think this kid's gonna sell, huh?
You saw that crowd, they'll eat him up.
It's gonna be tough to handle, he's such a punk.
Well, now that's your job. I'm going home.
I'm going home.
See, he couldn't actually afford to lose that deal, but he had to sell it as though the kid was a commodity.
He's got a kid brother named Ted someplace. He wants to make some dough to keep him in college. He told me about it riding out from town.
Well, what his brother don't know won't hurt him.
Man, he really does look like a rat, including the fucking gap in his teeth big enough for a truck to drive through.
I know the mafia.
Picture Red Tootie next to him. I mean, it looked just like him.
Jesus,
no,
yeah.
No, the corporation was a partnership. I had the mafia kill my partner. That's not a joke, but he probably, like, literally did that.
Oh, Jesus.
I miss my partner.
I miss my boyfriend.
I miss my annoying partner that I hated so much.
I had him killed by the mafia.
I only saw him for, like, essentially 5 minutes of this whole film, and yet I want to have his kid so bad.
Who the fuck's doing laundry?
Yeah, that's what I was asking earlier. I think it's Kitty.
What?
I hear your laundry spinning.
Oh, yeah, my My husband wanted to do his laundry. I'm sorry.
Was there supposed to be something?
Yeah. Can you tell him I got tested today? I think I might have gonorrhea.
Here.
What's this for?
What was that? It's a lie. Yeah, that lie was so oddly delivered. What's this for?
Take it, kid. You'll be able to buy a house with that.
They are, like, comically awful to people.
Welcome to the record label industry.
I ordered you a steak when I heard you moving around in there.
A steak? For breakfast?
What else is there?
Eggs. Eggs.
Eggy!
Brown sugar! Eggy! Lard!
What did Vicky say? Did she understand why I didn't make it? She didn't show up herself.
They just lie, wow.
There isn't anybody there, just some hashlinger. I gave her the $10.
Gave him a single dollar. He had to lie about that, too?
You think somebody really does that? Just go around telling people lies?
Yes.
I don't even have fucking $10 to spare with a brat like you.
I can't understand about Vicky, though. Not even to leave a word or anything. You say, she was on the program too last night?
Yeah, she was on before I was.
Well, that's simple. Mike signed you and not her.
You mean she was jealous?
Could be. That's the best thing some of them chicks do.
I feel like they're crooked in more ways than one.
They're part of the cartel.
If the talent doesn't agree, we kill him. No one else can have him.
If I can't have you, no one can.
Last night on Hal Kenton's TV show, a star was really born. After a somewhat less than graceful entrance...
I'm sorry, it was a wire. I caught my foot in a wire.
I'm sorry. Why does he sound like he's so dumb?
Bud Eagle came on like gangbusters. His singing brought the audience to its feet and swamped the switchboard with calls. Four record companies are waiving contracts.
Four record companies want me?
Golly!
I can't even think straight.
I just coomed.
Just coomed, shut up.
God damn it.
He's already, like, manipulating him. You don't believe what the media think, only what I think. Like, what is this? A fucking record company or a cult?
Both. Yes.
Yeah.
Property. I like people. Owning people.
This is like a legalized version of slavery.
I mean, look what happened with Britney Spears.
Her fucking dad.
Oh, gee, thanks, Mike.
Yeah, just don't set it on fire once you're done performing it. We had one guy do it, and I gave him hell for it.
Listen, I don't think he's Jimi Hendrix, but okay.
Oh, I'm gonna make some records!
Great.
Did you have to shove... Did you have to shove me into the fucking chair to say that?
Listen, that guy was really excited.
I see less excitement with Tom Cruise, like, being in love with Katie Holmes on Oprah.
I'm in love with Katie Holmes! I'm in love with Katie Holmes! I'm not gay! Go see my new movie! I'm in love with Katie Holmes!
I wrote a letter to my brother Ted last night. Can I mail it someplace around here? Here, I'll take care of it.
I'm gonna have that shred up.
This is, like, fucking needlessly evil. I can't even mail a fucking letter?
I drink out of a sippy cup now.
I finally left the high chair.
Now I can see the world for what it is.
My high chair is gonna be there with all everything everywhere. I'm gonna shit in my diaper. I'm gonna goo goo ga.
Jesus fuck. Call her a man child.
Oh my god. This guy.
I'm a man child. I like to.
There's like a theme in that last Elvis Presley movie. We made Elvis Presley like a freaking neurodivergent man who was obsessed with cows. Are we about to do the same thing with this guy?
I'm fucking worried now. Jesus, like, I mean, this guy, he doesn't sound bad. He.
What's the punch?
Jesus, I think we got an earlier look at Stephen fucking Miller. Jesus.
Oh, what the fuck?
She's fucking tripping balls.
People just getting high. Jesus.
What'd you tell him? Just what you told me to tell him.
Gonna make some records, do some shows. Be a long time before any money comes.
Yeah, that ought to hold him for a while.
Oh, by the way, New York called 3 times.
Long distance, please. Circle 23,000, New York. It's Macaulay speaking.
Macaulay Culkin?
Hey, Culkin, man.
Bud Eagle? For $500?
$500? I sold fucking Def Leppard for $1,000.
Damn, more than $500 back in the day, that would have been a lot of money.
You could probably get a whole ass train with that.
You could buy land with that shit.
Let's see, we have a devotion. Yeah, good idea.
Devotion?
Oh, the return of the Goodfellas Stooges.
Character from How to Train a Wild Bikini.
Run that by me again?
There is a movie. Okay, so the Beach Blanket Bingo series, they're called the Beach Party Movies. And one of the characters had a little gang in How to Train a Wild Bikini or Tame a Wild Bikini. And it was this like wannabe like late 50s like greaser that was in there. And it was just a goofball like that. I really want us to watch the Beach Blanket Bingo or the Beach Party series. They're great.
I love it.
They're so groovy.
Well, I think our next movie obviously should be that. I saved some.
You really fell for that guy, didn't you?
Just like a ton of bricks. I didn't know myself until...
Have you heard from him lately?
No.
I just wondered. You hadn't said... Here. Take this dime and go play the other side.
What am I supposed to buy with a dime?
He left me. Somebody else. Oh, that guy's like... Get him go. He's like James Dean, but like crappier. He's like Dollar Store James Dean and fucking Elvis Presley. Look at him! You're not no Roy Orsman. Anything you want,
you got it. He's not popular enough for a fucking future analog horror series to make president out of.
Hello, Bud. Come on in. Bud, these are the presidents of your fan club.
Sir? Bad idea to bring up some people. I just shat my pants.
What's wrong with his hair?
This one wants to suck your penis, and the other one wants to suck on your finger and rub your hair.
I could get down with this.
Can we watch Cry Baby this summer?
Showtime, folks. Enjoy the show.
What do you think, Karen?
I think he's cute.
Awooga!
What about tearing off his clothes?
That's for squares.
I think it's effective.
I agree with Karen. But you check with me first because suits cost money.
Speaking of money, Mike.
The usual rates will apply.
Cost of living's going up, up, up.
Oh, so you know about the inflation crisis. I'm so glad.
Nice that a movie finish, from man. The 60s is keeping up with the fucking inflation of 2022.
I have to ponder with my hands behind my back and pace.
What kind of a fad do you want us to start?
Eagle feathers. You wear them behind your ear, you stick them in your hair, you put them around your wrist.
Wouldn't that be insensitive to Native Americans and indigenous tribes?
Only if you wear an Indian headdress. I'm not talking about a headdress, just a single feather.
Just a real dress. I want to look pretty.
Stick them up your asshole for all I care. The homosexual community can get involved. I want Sunday schools. I want churches. I want elementary schools, goddammit.
I want pictures of Spider-Man right now.
Right now. J. Jonah Jameson's grandfather.
Who's Spider-Man?
Well, actually, Spider-Man was a cereal in the 50s, so...
Oh.
What about us, Mike? Stockholders.
Now, let me tell you punk something. A stockholder is generally a guy that never makes a nickel.
A nipple.
A nipple?
I think you said a nickel.
We sound like a nipple. He never makes a nipple, guys. I don't even know what's going on. I've lost like halfway like going on this film.
We're at the halfway mark, though.
You guys were like, I'm not trying to be mean. You guys talked a lot. So I couldn't really follow it. All I know is the guy got owned by a record label, and now here's like the Mickey Mouse fan club over here trying to make hype the hype squad, and then here's like dollar store James Dean over here.
Well, that's you're actually all caught up, really.
Yeah. Okay, I'm glad I kept up.
Someplace? Home, maybe. I haven't liked the last couple letters I've been getting from Ted. They don't sound like him at all. That's not all. Does everything have to be so phony?
Bud, you're in a serious business. We've got a product to sell. You. To sell our product, we advertise, we publicize, we promote every angle to increase sales. Now, in the course of this business, we use fan clubs. Fan clubs are very important in this business. You know, if people don't like a kind of candy bar, they won't buy it. Life is a big game of follow the leader. That's the way of the world, kid. Get with it.
I don't think you're right, Mr. Mercalli. And I don't think I have to be a part of it.
I admire you for that. If more people thought like you, we wouldn't have so many crooked politicians and payola and brainwashing. I told you this is serious business. Steak.
I'm sorry. The fucking Rat Fink is called steak?
I love steak.
I can't eat steak. My stomach can't take it.
I haven't had steak in fucking ages.
Doesn't Dairy Queen have it?
Yeah.
While these motherfuckers are talking about Dairy Queen, I want myself a sandwich from Five Guys.
Let me tell you who makes a good sandwich. That Sharp Wing guy.
I don't make sandwiches.
Fucking
yes, he does.
Five Guys is kind of overpriced, really, especially when I tried it in the Baltimore area.
Oh, I can't wait to go to a diner this summer.
One of the best fucking burgers in the world.
Oh, guess what? I'm going to the drive-in this summer. I'm so excited.
What are you going to try to see?
I have no idea, but I want to go to the drive-in with my husband and the Cavalier. I mean, the Cavalier.
Y'all just gonna fuck.
Oh,
ah, seizures! Jesus fuck, seizures!
I'm Darren.
You're ruining those records.
Who cares?
Oh, that's implying how much money and records he's selling.
Yes, symbolic reference.
Oh my god, they're wearing the feathers. I don't know
how to... Jesus fuck. Oh hey, it's the babushka lady from the fucking Zabruder film.
Baba booey, baba booey.
Oh god damn it!
Oh god, the pompadour got more pompadour.
My hair grows with every song.
Pierce
I swear
more.
To god if that actually
Could
happens.
Can we ever watch American Graffiti? Oh, I love this interpretation.
I doubt we'd be able to pull it off, but if we could, we should.
I have it all on my computer.
But, I mean, just to be able to just watch it without all of a sudden YouTube having a conniption fit. A copyright conniption.
Conniption?
I hate you. She's like, just his eyes. I'm like, I hate you. You fucking took my career. You took my money. You took my glory. And I will find you and kill you.
She certainly is fucking looking pissed while being dressed as a fucking dollar store Marilyn Monroe. Christ.
If you want to kill me, I'd be happy for you to. Man looks like he wants to die. It's not the look of a happy, happy man.
And I had to play second fiddle to the Beatles. God damn it. The Beatlemania fucking killed me, dude.
You get me a woman on that stage in a skin-tight, sparkly suit, dancing around like an idiot, waving around a piece of cloth and entertaining people while he sings.
I bet they're all looking at her boobs instead of listening to me.
Yeah.
Boobies.
Sex appeal.
Having boobies can be a talent sometimes for some.
Having boobies can be a talent. It's otherworldly.
Yup.
She just like died on the stage.
I do kind of love how these films did darkness as well. so eerie.
Well, it's the some okay, so this is like the era where Technicolor was, even though it was a thing, it still was it was expensive.
You're just gonna get hit by a car. Oh man.
So a lot of black and white films were still common back then, if you will. And fun fact, those who dream in black and white were exposed to black and white films back in the day. Those who dream in color were exposed to more color films and media.
I wonder what the first color film was.
I think it was The Wizard of Oz, I want to say.
Yeah, I'm thinking that too.
Apparently, the first colored movies was commercially produced was Visit to Seaside in 1908.
Yeah, 8-minute British short film that tries scent kinema color. I don't know why they spelled it with a K.
It must kinema. Be a different type of color technology.
Or something crazily, you know, advanced like... what was the fucking technique that they used in fucking Clutch Cargo? The serial where they basically plaster live mouths over fucking cartoon cells. But yeah, sometimes they make it sound futuristic and catchy and shit. And strangely enough, too, because the previous film, Iga...
What? Oh, ice skating.
It's especially strange because the previous film to this, Iga, was indeed filmed in color. And it was shown in color when Mystery Science Theater 3000 ripped it.
Bitch, I thought you meant roller skating, not ice skating. Jesus.
They put the same thing.
Either one, you slip and fall.
He's like checking out her ass. Oh,
that's some good shit. Playboy can't buy this kind of entertainment.
Welcome to the 1962 Winter Olympics.
Oh.
Now, where the fuck is that Tatiana Otter girl?
Bitch, this would have been too lewd, like, back in the day. Holy shit. You can see her underwear and shit.
No, I she's mean, technically just... wearing the proper garment, so that's probably why it's not super lewd. But his face is, like, making it that way.
Oh, those shorts, what they do to me. Oh.
Boingo, boingo.
You know what? Permitted.
It's nice that Zach and Kelly finally got together.
Oh my god.
Easy there. Let's not decapitate him. Fucking Christ. We don't want another Tonya Harding
like
incident.
Beyblade.
Let it rip.
Beyblade.
Just concentrate on standing up and just moving about instead of these complicated moves there, bud.
Try not to poop myself. Jesus Christ. Okay, I can do this.
Yeah, let's just concentrate on the movement and balance.
Your legs are so nice.
God, if only the boss hadn't put so much cocaine in me.
Ah, ooh. Kiss. Why okay. not?
Why does your mouth taste like burning? I'll explain later.
Oh, wait, that's me. I'm having a stroke.
Oh, God.
That was the cigarette I ate. I'm sorry.
You ate the cigarette?
I'm referencing Grease 2, for those that don't know. Oh, they skated all into the night, and it's like 3
saliva probably would douse a piping hot cigarette.
I love doing things like that with my husband. It's so romantic.
Romantic. Ricky, you and Sauce should do something like that.
Walk in the middle of a highway.
Yeah, holding up traffic.
No, I think it's cute that he gave her jacket and lift her chin up and fucking
I guess they looked away because that's the scene I saw was them walking on a highway.
Oh, God.
Are those naked men on his table?
She was talking about the whole ice skating thing, I think.
Check out these statues. They're pretty cool.
Guess what's in the box?
What's in the fucking... Oh.
Just kidding.
Damn it. I can't do a 7 joke. Fuck.
No, now you can write songs while you're on the move. I've noticed you haven't been writing many songs lately.
I've been a little busy.
Oh, come on, I brought him the prototype for the Walkman and everything.
What's the matter with that kid?
He saw that girl again.
We can't have that. If he wants a girl, get one for him.
How about Daisy?
Why not?
Pardon the intrusion, but I just had to see if Mike was too cheap to even change the lock.
You're Don Proctor, aren't you?
That I am.
Did I ever tell you about the Reagan administration?
Oh my god! You guys are.
Get you some drink. You're gonna love this.
I used to be one of Mike McCauley's trained SEALs. A few years ago, the fashion was handsome young men with wavy hair. Now it's kids. You don't even have to understand a word.
Yeah, take a look at fucking mumble rap. You can't even understand a goddamn fucking word.
So, anyway, I hooked up with Mike McCauley. He treated me royally. He moved me in here and he gave me that funny monkey steak as a bodyguard and major domo.
Why do you keep pouring it in a glass? You seem to be such an alcoholic, you might as well be drinking straight from the fucking bottle.
Did you ever have to pay for anything?
No.
Because you can't. You haven't got any money, have you?
No, I don't.
That's part of the golden leash. Give him everything, but keep him broke so he can't get away.
Well, you got it back, didn't you?
Why, it didn't even dent the expenses. Come on down to the office sometime. Take a look at the books. And that guitar that you're taking with you, for instance.
Maybe you can sell it.
Maybe. But how about all those suits that are hanging in the closet? How much do you suppose I could get on them? I'm on the hook for plenty, but that's okay. I'd rather lose $50,000 than to see you lose your ideals.
$50,000?
I told you this is serious business.
He owns you, son. Take warning. He'd be a part of the African slave trade if it was just a few years ago.
Well, I don't have a feeling we have a dark look into how Billy Joel fucking... how he came to terms with how he's no longer successful. You never
heard of a fast pencil? I used to be the piano man.
Mike will show you a set of books that turns over and plays dead. Every nickel that comes in goes out for expenses.
How do I know you're not just saying all this?
You don't, kid.
By the way, are we going to talk about how you broke into my house and drank all my fucking liquor?
Nope.
Oh, sorry, gotta go.
What the hell?
I'm looking for 101 Dalmatians.
But first, let me give you a doggy treat.
Doggy.
Oh, okay. Nope. Are we, like, touching on cougar territory?
Uh-huh. No, mommy be Betty, no.
Fuck!
She was wearing arsenic lipstick.
Nice to know we're getting a fucking early leaked video of Madison Cawthorn.
I'm the type of guy that drinks alcohol.
He's trying to get away from her.
Ew, cooties, no.
No, he knows what they're trying to do, I think.
100%.
The alcoholic was right, the darkness descends.
Bet you'll still wind up in a compromising position with your girlfriend finding out and she'll be fucking overreacting. Because that's what they always do in fucking harems! When you go through a lot of anime, you see a lot of tropes, you sometimes just get sick of them.
Come on, you're going home.
I don't want to go home.
You said you're going home. Does this make you change your mind?
Yeah. Same old steak.
Let's go.
Here we go again.
Steak gonna wind up shooting that guy, I wonder.
No, I want to be gay! Let me stay gay!
Let me have my virginity, please!
Here comes
don't
the
take
straight
it away
game.
From me!
Record company owns it.
They own her. They own his virginity.
Signed it away in that contract.
Oh!
Killed him.
Johnny, no!
Ah, fuck! I didn't have to fucking fire a shot!
Stella! Get back in here!
I'm coming, Stanley. I'm coming.
Mommy Tyrus filming in the next apartment over.
Tina! Bring me the axe!
Get away from me, you crazy bitch. What are you doing?
This I'm surprised Bud hasn't fucking just taken her and threw her into the fucking water. I bet it's gonna fucking happen.
Oh god, no. What's she doing? She took off her gloves. This is serious.
He's like, boobies.
You're gonna move? Fucking hell!
Listen, she's doing a build-up. This
oh
is
no,
a
she took off her
I'm talking about Bud here.
Period. Get off me. Ah!
And she's gonna walk in?
This is rape. I do not consent.
Right about now.
I called it.
Like fucking clockwork!
Wait,
Oh, Johnny, how could you?
Well, her job's done.
What the fuck?
The bees.
It's a finger. The wiggling. Oh. Wiggle finger. Come here, kid. I got something to show you. Come here.
Fucking early Pennywise scenes from It.
Yes, we all float down here, Johnny boy. We all float down here. You'll float too.
What's with you guys? Bunch of kooks or something?
Bunch of kooks. I like that. I'm going to use some that from now on. More kooks.
Why is everybody's face covered but mine? They're going to recognize me.
Look, he is an anti-masker. He does not believe in COVID.
Don't worry. We'll be putting a mask over your face. Nobody will know.
I had facial reconstruction surgery.
I'm hideous.
Don't look at me. I don't even have a dime. I got it. What say we walk?
Cheat that smart thinking brains.
Ba-dum-ba-dum. Like, literally, we got the Three Stooges here.
Where's the kid?
I killed him.
You weren't supposed to kill him! He's our fucking talent!
I'm your talent now.
The fucking bimbo!
Slapping her.
Damn, perfect timing.
Goddamn fame-hungry bimbos.
You bimbo!
It's time to engage for our comedic interrogation.
We done it, Weasel, we done it! We're in the big time!
Some people wanted to be on the silver screen, and some people obviously want to be on fucking America's Most Wanted.
Let me get this straight now. You guys have kidnapped me, and you're gonna hold me for a ransom, right?
Now, we have evaluated your worthiness, and we have concluded that you are worth 5 G's.
You're worth more than that.
I'm gonna buy me one of the motorboats, one of them kind that cut through the water like...
what are we doing? Like, little kid noises now?
Well, it's pretty obvious. They got the educational level of a fucking toddler.
Oh, boy.
We don't know proper gun safety.
Hold it, you. One more step and I'll fill you full of holes.
Gee, just like in the moving pictures.
Hey, did you ever see it done better?
Shit.
You're a dumbass if you're really that fucking easy to overcome.
Jason Bourne over here disarmed me with his hands.
And I'm a fucking goddamn hick.
You know, we did call him a hick. I think he's more of a bitch.
Are you guys really supposed to be crooks? And kidnappers?
No, we're the Three Stooges. What the fuck do you think we are?
We're good fellas, you see?
We're Dollar Tree Sopranos.
You're like three different Timon and Pumbas.
I hate you.
But Timon and Pumbaa is only a team of two. Well, then somebody's Simba, and it ain't me. That defeats the purpose, don't it? Stop, I never went to school. I'm a hick, right?
Hey, you ain't fooling me, wise guy. You know when you're up against some pretty tough boys, and you're scared, right?
I don't know, man. I just easily disarmed you, and you just looked away. I don't think you're that intimidating.
I'm highly intimidated. I'm pooping my pompadour right now. That's more like
you. You were gonna write a ransom note, weren't you?
Brains? To be sure. A ransom note. The very thing.
You're not supposed to write dummy. You're supposed to pick out letters from like a magazine or something. Because they would probably take to your handwritings and shit, right?
Wouldn't they just pinpoint what stores we bought the magazines from?
I probably shouldn't have signed it too.
You signed the ransom note.
If we're gonna do this, let's do it big. I should be worth at least 15,000.
Are you sure they're gonna pay?
If they'll pay 5, they'll pay 15.
You know, there's an elephant of truth there.
Aren't elephants white lies, though?
Are they out of their copy-picking mind?
I guess they found out your whole heart, Mike.
Well, what's so funny about it?
I don't know. I guess it's the fact you're going to have to shell out for a change.
Oh, big joke.
It's okay. We'll kill them. Guarantee he didn't put 15 grand in that box, in that bag.
It's probably like a prick and like $2 bills.
A phone book. Hope you like Alexander Graham Bell, bitches. They really just peeked their heads out of a corner, Looney Tunes style. Watch, I bet the bodyguard's ready to point a gun at them.
Hey!
I found the money!
That's loud and that's delivery! We found the money! Go back to the shack.
I'm gonna follow him.
To the love shack where we're
you know what these guys remind me of? The ransom. And we are number one meme.
Oh, Jesus, fuck.
We are number one.
I bet it's like fake money or something.
Or they probably tailed him.
Stay!
Oh, Stick's about to kill somebody!
He's got that angry look on his face.
I get to shoot a gun!
He brought his angry eyes with him today. He's ready to kill.
That's a... Dumbass!
Are they hiding with mattresses and shit?
One guy just tried to climb a ladder that led to a fucking ceiling.
Why are pillows so heavy?
Ooh.
Are there dead bodies in the shed? There's like skeletons or some shit.
Where the hell are they in Skeletor's lair?
God damn it, the Three Stooges got away. I was gonna kill
you
all of them.
You couldn't even rescue your way out of a goddamn garbage bag!
Extra, extra, read all about it, buddy, go missing.
Paper, sir?
I like how you went from shouting to like, hey!
They're all wearing feathers in their hair.
Steak was just gonna straight out kill them.
I love the little gloves on her hands. I wish that came back into fashion.
Have you heard any news about Bud?
No.
I wonder what could have happened to him.
I swear I'm not hiding him.
See this cup?
This cup stinks.
See how clean it is. I got me a new dishwasher. He came in the other day. He was hungry. Needed a place to sleep.
Plot twist. It's that guy.
Hey, you in there?
You want me, Marge?
Bud!
Vicky!
Oh, I nearly got myself stabbed because of that fucking comic fall.
There's a knife in my elbow.
How about we talk about the knife in my back there, bud?
Came here because, well, I had to have a place to think.
Oh, I imagine it would be very difficult to concentrate with that girl.
Always with the misunderstanding. Typical common anime trope.
Did you? Glad.
Just like eat each other's faces.
Why, of course it's a publicity stunt. I'm surprised, Ed, that an old hand like you fell for that. Why, it'll hit every newspaper in the country. Record sales will go to the top. Hey, how's the weather in Philadelphia?
Okay. So long,
Ed. Must not have been very good weather.
If that kid don't show up, I'm the one that's going down the drain. I ought to take it out of your hide.
Don't worry about it. I got kids looking for him all over town.
Well, they better. And it cost me $5,000 to square it with Don Proctor.
I told you, he fell down the steps. Fell!
Yeah.
Well, Mr. McCullough, you don't know me, but I need $20.
Get lost.
I guess I'll just have to go to the newspapers.
The fuck you talking about?
Bud Eagle.
You know where he is?
Sure.
Well, where is he?
That's my pitch, Mr. McCauley. For $20, I won't tell the newspapers.
For $20, I'll call you a chicken fucker.
Thanks.
Where's Bud?
Oh, he's at the Coffee Cup Cafe on La Brea. He's working as a dishwasher.
Well, why didn't you think of that? Of course that's where he is. Where the girl stays. We're back in business again and bigger than ever. I can just see it now. Boy goes to cafe to see girl. Young love.
Why was I worried about love affairs? Gossip also sells too.
Girl.
Suppose the kid doesn't want to cooperate.
Oh, you'll cooperate.
I don't know about that.
A girl's got a pretty face, hasn't she?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Great. I bet they're gonna take me out because I'm not doing music for them.
We're gonna kidnap the girl and hold her for ransom. Do a music.
Beat your girl up. Son, I assume you ain't been keeping up with the cocaine.
We've sold 4 million records, we've done 7 TV shows, and I don't know how many personal appearances. Now, every kid in this country is buying stuff with my picture on it, and I haven't got anything on it except 6 suits and 1 new guitar.
Are you saying I cheated you?
Didn't you?
You want to come down to the office and look at the books?
No, Mike, not those books. But I'll tell you what I will do. You can have everything you've got up until now. And we're going to start a new set of books for that tour you got lined up for me. Another thing, new bookkeeper. And I'm going to live by myself, and I'm going to handle my own money.
You smart punk. Who do you think you are?
Problem is, I can kill you. That guy has a gun.
Or hell, yeah, we could just cut your brake lines and make it look like an accident.
How about it, Mike? Is it a deal?
You little punk. You sing for me or you sing for nobody, and get this straight.
That smoke is getting to me.
What would all of those nice kids back in your hometown think if they knew what you were really like? Daisy, for instance.
I never had anything to do with her.
Yeah, but she'll say anything I tell her to say. And the stories that I can spread make mighty good reading back in your hometown.
What a bastard.
Thank God I picked a fucking movie that isn't so fucking whitewashed or cheesy as fuck. Feel-good story. I would imagine that this kind of bullshit happens all the time. Just a little bit less messy.
If I get a new manager, you're gonna spread a lot of lies about me. And if I don't sing at all, you're gonna try to hurt Vicky. Is that right?
Kid, don't you hear good? That's exactly right.
Hey, bud, we're out of tape.
It's okay, we've got everything.
Tape!
That's too late, you old bastard.
Oh, my face.
Damn it, I'm doing it by doors. How do they work?
I don't know how to kick down a door. I'm rich and white.
Open sesame.
That's what the bodyguard does for me. That's why he has a gun. You think I know how to shoot?
Groovy. Whoa, whoa, whoa. What the hell was that?
Did that shit just to fuck with him.
Yeah, I do my own fucking stunts, bitch.
I love those punch sounds too, just a slap, 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 slap.
What the fuck was that shit?
That's the most intense punching you've ever heard in a movie.
It's like he's trying to pick him up, trying to do like a pile driver or something, but he fucked it up badly.
We're slapping baloney against tile right here. Curses.
Sorry, kid. I forgot how doors work. Sorry.
My oldest enemy has defeated me.
I wouldn't keep you around, but Bud thinks he can use you. He says you're smart.
Nice of you to say that, Bud.
So stay smart.
Unfortunately, not smart enough, because I think we're missing a few frames.
Now it's my turn to give you one. Let's say we get some real teamwork going from now on.
Wait, you aren't going to try and thwart me and destroy my business? You just want a fair wage?
Don't you think Vicky's great? Yeah, man. You get a lot of nice cocaine, and might as well get some of that as well.
Well, I already gave you plenty of cocaine.
Oh, what did you do? Oh.
We're now on location of the next Bud Eagle music video.
I'm not the villain now because you have dirt on me.
We're in the Los Angeles sewer.
There's poop in the sewer.
Similar outfit to what he ended up wearing in Ika.
I dig it. It's such a gas.
I have gas. In my motorcycle.
Careful, otherwise he wind up with nothing left for his motorcycle.
Look at them shaking them bippies.
That man's wearing a Speedo. I love it.
One guy in a suit dancing on a fucking beach.
Well, I took her to a doctor, gonna find out what to do.
I took her to a doctor.
Baby's got twist fever. It's like a fucking virus, man.
Why do I feel like this guy was a real celebrity?
Well, short-lived career. I mean, only a few songs, a few movies, and then he decided... He decided to retire on a good note, and then he became a airline pilot.
Yeah, made his fortune and then quit, and then probably died in a plane crash.
No, I think he lived a long, healthy life, I believe. I think he's still alive.
That's pretty optimistic. I don't believe it.
rave on.
Yeah, he's still alive. He's currently 78 right now.
Arch Hall Jr.
Hell should we have an interview with him? See how it was his time on the movie?
I don't think he even remembers at one point. I bet.
That's the Adderall.
The Adderall. You know what? Sure. Why not?
But yeah, Wild Guitar. What do you guys think?
It was a gas. So far out.
Sorry. His bike's ruined.
It's okay. Yeah, that fucking shit's flooded. After that, yeah.
His bike is just ruined.
That's not going to start again. That's not going to start again.
Fuck, I should have been paying attention. The target's coming up.
Good evening. It's intermission.
But it looks so cool. It makes some great album art.
We invite you to visit our refreshment stand.
I actually kind of like the movie. I found it, like, weirdly charming.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Our service
it was a ball.
I mean, it was like
a good nanny.
It was like one of those.
Your favorite candy. It was like what you expect one of those classic movies.
Gonzo, don't you think it was a Hootenberry?
And to your fun of watching the movie, visit our refreshment stand.
You have no idea what I'm saying, do you?
We're glad to have you with us tonight.
Such a Hootenberry, guys. I mean, right?
It's great to get out to the movies.
It's a Hootenberry situation type deal. Oh my god. Rock, 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 rock. No, you rock. Rock.
Okay, I'm gonna stop right here.
We hope you have a wonderful time. Come back soon.
Hit me. Hit me!
Sure!